Hey there! Kids, we have learned that synthetic fibers are of primarily four types. These are rayon, polyester, nylon, and acrylic. Now, students, have you ever thought that when we already had natural fibers, when we already had cotton, silk, jute, then what was the need of making these synthetic fibers? When the fibers were already present in the nature, then why did we make these fibers on our own? You don't know? Well, no problem. Every fiber has its own history. And here in this lesson, if we focus upon a very, very beautiful natural fiber, which is the silk, we see, in fact, you have learned that in your previous standard also, that silk is a natural fiber. But at the same time, the fabrics which are made from the natural fibers, they are very costly. But because of their beautiful texture, like you can see, it's so shiny, right? Its appearance, its feel is very nice. So it fascinates everyone. So now, scientists, they had to do something because everybody wanted silk, and obviously, since it is a natural fiber, it is expensive and also its quantity is also limited. Okay, so what was done? There were many attempts made to make silk artificially, and this silk would be cheaper than this natural silk. Now, towards the end of 19th century, when people realized that this silk moth cannot make as much as silk which was in demand, scientists were successful in obtaining fibers having properties very similar to this silk. Yes. And this new type of fiber, which was very similar to the silk, was rayon. So rayon is also termed as artificial silk. In this lesson, we will be focusing upon the properties and the uses of rayon here. Alright, so let's move forward and talk a little more about this amazing fiber, which is also called artificial silk. So moving forward, when we see rayon, we see that actually, rayon is made from a very natural process. Here we observe that the process of making rayon fiber is kind of natural. But now it creates a confusion. It creates a confusion that if it is working or it is made from a natural fiber, then how do we call it a synthetic fiber? Well, let's first understand the process and I'll then tell you why do we still call it a synthetic fiber. Okay, so in the process of making rayon fiber, trees are required. Yes, your trees are required. So like in case of silk, the silk moth was required, the silk worm was required, right? Similarly here, the trees are required. Now what happens here? Well, when the trees are cut down, the logs or the wood is collected. Okay? And from this wood, we can collect the wood pulp. Got it? So from the wood, we are collecting the wood pulp. Now, one thing that you must note down and you must notice here is that the wood contains a lot of cellulose. What does it contain? It contains a lot of cellulose. Cellulose is a type of carbohydrate. So this cellulose is actually the cellulose which makes cotton also. Okay, so wood pulp contains a lot of cellulose. So now what is cellulose? It is a natural resource. So we are using a natural resource here for the making of this synthetic fiber. Now in the next step, what we will do? Well, we will take this wood pulp. Then we will take some sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide solution is a chemical solution. Okay, when both of these are mixed together in a vessel, after some time it is observed that it forms a sticky liquid which is called viscose. What do you call it? You call it viscose. So what is viscose? Basically, viscose is nothing but a sticky liquid which is formed by dissolving the wood pulp in sodium hydroxide. Now what will happen? Well, this sticky liquid will be passed through a machinery. It will be passed through a metal cylinder. So if we look in here, you will observe that it is passed through this machinery. It might look a little complicated, but I'll just explain it for you. So here you see that when the fibers from this end, when they are passed through this, which is called spinneret, you can see here that if you pass this liquid from this spinneret having very tiny holes, it gives out these tiny threads. These thin threads are actually the threads of rayon. Okay, so here the collection of thread is happening across this machinery, and at the end in the spinning box, the entire set of rayon batch can be obtained. Got it? So what I just said, that the viscose is forced to pass through these tiny holes of a metal cylinder, which we also call as spinneret. Okay. It is passed into a solution of acid. It is passed into a solution of acid where the silk-like thread is obtained in this spinning box. And what is this thread? Yes, it is the rayon thread. Now, when these rayons, they are woven like this, we find that we can have rayon fabric. Now, if you compare this rayon fabric now with silk, what do you see? Well, yes, these two look very similar, aren't they? So that is why we can say that rayon is what? Artificial silk. Don't forget that, okay? It is very important. In the exam, they can ask you that why do you call it artificial silk? So what will you say? You'll say because it resembles the silk in appearance. But if you talk about the composition, what do you say? Well, here we see that rayon is actually made up of cellulose. Cellulose is what? It is a natural resource. So that is the reason why we can say that rayon is neither a fully synthetic nor a fully natural fiber. Okay? Do remember this, that yes, do we call it a synthetic fiber, but it is not a fully synthetic fiber. Because for synthetic fibers, we have learned that it has to be man-made. It has to be chemical compounds, right? But then the question arises, what do we call them? Well, you can call them semi-synthetic fiber. So rayon is what? It is a semi-synthetic fiber. Got it? But now in the exam, if they ask you that why is rayon called a man-made fiber? If you are using cellulose to make it, why can't you call it a natural fiber simply? Well, you cannot do that because rayon is obtained by the chemical treatment of wood pulp in the factories. Okay, so this gives it an edge to call it a synthetic fiber. The reason is because it is obtained by the chemical treatment. So now since you're adding chemicals to this fiber, that's why you call it a man-made fiber or artificial fiber or synthetic fiber. Got it there? It is clear, right? So now we know why rayon is called a semi-synthetic fiber or a man-made fiber. But one thing that we are not forgetting is that the basic unit of rayon is cellulose, which is as same as cotton. Cotton also has cellulose. If you remember, we have learnt it earlier also. Cotton has the basic unit as cellulose, and so does rayon. Okay? So moving forward, if we talk about the properties, If we talk about the properties of rayon, first of all, we will mention this point here that it is chemically identical to cotton. Yes, we just learned it, right? It is chemically identical to cotton. Why? Because chemically, both cotton and rayon are made up of cellulose. So this can be another question in your exam, students, that how can you relate rayon and cotton? What will you say? You will say that both of them are made up of cellulose. And where do you obtain the cellulose from? Yes, from the wood. Okay. Next to this, we see that physically it is similar to silk, right? That is why, what do you call it? Artificial silk. All right. Next, we see that it is actually cheaper than the natural fiber. Okay, which is the silk. So it is cheaper than the silk. And lastly, we can see that you can actually dye. This fiber can be dyed in a variety of colors. Got it? So these are some of the very basic properties of rayon. The first two are super important and they can be asked in the exam also, and you must remember them. Got it? Moving forward, if we learn about some of the uses. So how will you use rayon? Well, some uses are very common and very obvious, which is like rayon is used in the textile industry for making clothes like the saris, the dresses and the socks. So all these, they can be made by rayon. So the industry, the textile industry takes full advantage of this lovely fiber, which is although natural, but still it is very, very cheap. Okay, so this is used in making a lot of clothes. Apart from clothes, we see that it is when mixed with cotton. If you mix it with cotton, it is used to make furnishings such as bed sheets, curtains and blankets. So the home furnishings that we have like bed sheets, curtains and blankets, they are also made by using rayon and they are mixed with cotton also. Okay, next we see that if or when you mix it with wool, it is used to make carpets. Yes, the thick carpets you have at your home, they also have some composition of rayon along with wool and other fibers. Okay, next to this, we see that rayon is not only used in home purposes, it is also used in the medical field. It is used in the medical field for making bandages and surgical dressings. Okay, so these bandages, they also have some part of rayon with them. Next to this, we see some more uses, for example, like it is used in the tire industry also, okay, for manufacturing of the tire cord. So these tire cords, they give strength to the tire. They are used in the tire industry and they are made with the help of rayon. So overall, we see there are many uses of rayon. All right, in the exam, they can again ask you the sum of them. So you must note down that they are used in the making of fabrics. Okay, they are used in the making of cloth. They are used in making of home furnishing products, right? In the tire industry and also in the medical industry. So overall, what we have learned? Well, we have learned about rayon as, first of all, it is a semi-synthetic fiber. Second, we see it is made up of cellulose. Third, we can also call it artificial silk. Next, we have learned that it is chemically identical to cotton. And lastly, we have learned some of its uses. Now, when you already know a lot about rayon, it is the time for quiz. So it's the quiz time. In the quiz, the first question I'm going to ask you is that rayon is different from truly synthetic fibers because, what is the answer? Well, your options are, first, because it has silk-like appearance. Second, if it is obtained from wood pulp. Third, its fibers can be woven like those of natural fibers. And fourth, it can be dyed in a variety of colors. So which of these is the correct reason why rayon is different from truly synthetic fibers. What do you think? Yes, you got it right. It is so because it is obtained from wood pulp. Wood pulp is a natural source and hence it is different from synthetic fibers. Good job there. Next question we are going to see is that the similarity between artificial silk and cotton is that? Well, such kind of questions you can definitely get in your exams also. They will not mention the term rayon. Rather, they will simply use the term artificial silk. Okay, so what is the similarity between these two? Well, your options are here. Like they both melt on heating, if they both are amide polymers, if they both are cellulose polymers, or if they both are synthetic fibers. Well, if you don't know the correct answer, another approach to find the right answer is by discarding the incorrect answers. Yes, so if they are synthetic fibers, well, cotton is not. If they both melt on heating, no, they don't. They burn on heating. If they are made up of amide polymers, well, we don't know what's that yet. And if it is made up of cellulose fibers, yes, they are made up of cellulose polymers. Yes, they are made up of cellulose, which is obtained from wood. Good job, guys, there. Last question is, which of the followings are not a use of rayon? Do you remember the uses? You do, right? So you have to tell me which of them are not uses of rayon. Your options are in making of clothes, in making sleeping bags, tire cord, toothbrushes, or carpets. Well, sleeping bags we haven't learned. Toothbrushes, no, you don't make toothbrushes with cloth material, do you? No. So what are the correct answers? Sleeping bags and toothbrushes. Other than these, the rayon is used in the making of carpets, tire cords and clothes also. So students, here you have learned everything about rayon, including its properties and its uses.